Sindhu Baye Vaja Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasari Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going through the fifth canto, and we're on chapter 18, where the residents of Jambudvip are offering prayers to the different, they're offering prayers to the Supreme Lord.
我们学习的是圣典博迦瓦坛第五篇第十八章。
So we were hearing the goddess of fortune Lakshmi offer prayers to the Supreme Lord.
我们听到的是, 幸运女神 Lakshmi Devi 向至尊人格守神供奉的祷文。
And she described how actually the Supreme Lord is the real husband of all living entities.
他描述了至尊人格守神实际上是所有一切生物真正的丈夫。She
said, anybody who's actually going to become a husband or a protector, they have to be able to give proper shelter to all people.
任何一个声称是丈夫或者保护者的人, 他应该给予这个被保护者真正的庇护。
So actually the Supreme Lord Vishnu, he's the only husband who can actually take that position properly.
因此事实上至尊人格守神他是Vishnu他是真正的保护者他应该是这个地位上的真正的人。
So people who have studied the Vedas properly, they know that the Supreme Lord is everyone's master.
因此一个精通所有伟大文献的人他知道主是所有人的主人。 And
they know there's no better husband, there's no better qualified person to protect them than the Supreme Lord.
他们会认为除了至尊主以外没有其他更好的丈夫和保护者。So
we should understand from these words of Lakshmi what it means to take this responsibility.
因此我们要了解Lakshmi所说的这段话的意思，我们知道他所承担的责任是什么。People
claim to be a husband, they claim to be a leader, they claim to be a, you know, to protect others, but their powers are very limited.
有些人声称自己是丈夫、保护者或者说一些领袖，但是他们 他们事实上不知道自己的这种地位的真正的含义。They
get these positions only by the mercy of the Lord, and the same mercy of the Lord takes them out of that position.
他们是从至尊主那里得到的仁慈来有的这个地位，至尊主也可以把这个仁慈把这个地位给拿走。So
people who are actually in knowledge, they will only see the Supreme Personality of Godhead as the real leader, as the real husband.
因此一个真正有知识的人，他会看到至尊主是唯一的保护者，唯一的主人，唯一的丈夫。Krishna
says in the Bhagavad Gita, he said, I will protect you from all sinful reactions, don't be afraid.
至尊主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中也说：“我将把你从所有的罪恶反应中拯救出来，请不要害怕。”Krishna
is not afraid of anybody. Everybody is afraid of Krishna.
Krishna 不害怕任何人，相反，每个人都害怕 Krishna.
So Krishna can actually give protection to people.
Krishna 才可以真正的给予每一个人保护。But
the other so-called big leaders, they're under the control of the material energy. They cannot give protection.
那些所谓的领袖和领导者，他们事实上是在物质自然的控制之下，他们不能给予真正的保护。
So it would be better if they stop fooling themselves. They cheat themselves, thinking that they're powerful.
他们事实上是愚昧的，所以他们拿走了这种力量。
But these big politicians and husbands, big businessmen, they actually get their power from Krishna.
这些人实际上他们是欺骗者，是愚昧的，是假装的。他们的力量会是从他们那里拿走的。他们有一天他们的这个力量也会被 Krishna 给拿走。
So they should use that power to spread the Krishna consciousness movement.
他们应该用这个力量传播 Krishna 知觉。
And then everyone can learn how to surrender to Krishna.
这样每一个人都会学习如何臣服 Krishna.
Because Krishna is the supreme husband.
因为 Krishna 是至尊的丈夫。
So Lakshmi continues, she says to the Lord that you satisfy every woman's desires. Any woman who worships you with pure love, you will fulfill their desires.
Lakshmi 向至尊主再一次祈祷道，亲爱的主，你自动地满足一个以纯粹爱心的人崇拜你莲花族的女人的所有愿望。
But if a woman worships the Lord for something material, then he may also fulfill her desires, but in the end she will become broken-hearted.
如果一个女人她以一种特殊的或者说物质愿望去崇拜至尊主的莲花族的话，主也会满足她的愿望，但是在最终的结果的时候，这个女士她会感到悲伤。
So we're warned, Lakshmi is warning the women, don't worship the Lord to get some material benefit.
在这里 Lakshmi 在警告所有的女士，不要带着物质愿望，用物质愿望去崇拜至尊主。
We should not worship the Supreme Lord just to get some material gain.
我们不应该崇拜至尊主，只是为了一些物质上的得益。
We should want to serve Him as He desires, not as we desire.
我们应该按照他的愿望去服务他，而不是要按照我们的愿望去服务他。
So, a new devotee, a neophyte devotee, they should worship Krishna according to the regulative principles given by the Guru.
因此，一位初级奉献者，一个新奉献者，应该根据灵性导师的或者规范原则，灵性导师给予的规范原则来崇拜至尊主。
We have to do devotional service guided by the Guru and also guided by Shastra.
我们应该做奉献服务是通过灵性导师以及经典。
And that way we will gradually will develop some attachment for Krishna.
这样的话我们就会发展出对 Krishna 的一些依附。
And then we will want to serve him without any thought of getting something material from him.
这样我们就会逐渐地发展出对他不带任何动机的这种服务。
Then it becomes pure devotion.
再然后就会发展出纯粹的奉献服务。
But if we are worshipping him to get something, to get some material gain, then this is not pure devotion.
如果我们服务主是为了一些物质上的收益或者说利益的话，这不是纯粹的奉献服务。
And the Lord looks after the devotees. You don't need to ask the Lord to take care of your comfort and to keep you safe. He will do it without you even asking him.
至尊主事实上是亲自照料这些奉献者。我们不需要向他去寻求或者说要求什么。他本来 原本他就会照顾这些奉献者。
If we are spending our time to serve him, he will take care to provide for his devotee.
如果我们花时间去崇拜他，他会照顾我们这些奉献者。
Whatever the devotee has, the Lord will protect it.
奉献者无论有什么，主都会保护他的这些。
And whatever the devotee needs, the Lord will supply it. He will provide it.
无论奉献者需要什么，主都会给予提供。
So there's no need to be praying to him to give us what we think we need.
因此，这么一来就没有必要向主祈祷，请给我一点什么，请得让我得到一些什么。
He knows what we need, and he will provide it.
他知道我们需要什么，他也会提供给我们这些。
However, even one great devotee, Vishwanatha Chakravarti, he's a great acharya.In the line, so he says that if a devotee wants to get something material, he shouldn't be considered wrong. He shouldn't be considered in Maya.
然而，在我们这个师徒传习中的一位离心导师圣维什巴纳查克瓦提塔库尔说，即便一位奉献者有一些物质的这种愿望去。服务或崇拜主的话，他不应该被视为处在玛雅之中。
Because Krishna says four kinds of pious people surrender to him.
因为 Krishna 也讲了四种虔诚的人对他做奉献服务。
So he's, you know, even though he's come to get some wealth or he's in some distress, he's come to Krishna, so he's considered very pious.
所以，即便他是追求财富的，或者说他很苦恼。他如果去寻求 Krishna 的庇护的话，他仍被视为是很虔诚的人。
It appears like they have some material desire, but they're just new devotees, so they don't really know. They don't know. They're ignorant about these things.
他们好像表面上看起来是有某种动机的这种奉献者，但是实际上他们只是一个初级奉献者。他们不知道他们的现在的这种情况而已。
And Krishna also says in the Bhagavad Gita, he says they're all great souls.
Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中也提到了，这些人事实上是伟大的灵魂。
And even though in the beginning they may have some material desire, gradually it will go away.
即便他们在开始的时候有一些物质的愿望，但是过了一段时间之后，这些物质愿望就会消失。
Some people would come to the Krishna consciousness movement, they were just attracted by the beautiful girls.
有一些人来到 Krishna 知觉，他仅仅有可能是被这个 Krishna 知觉一些漂亮的女孩所吸引。
Some people were just attracted by the free meal, the prasadam.
有一些人是被这个 Krishna 知觉的 prasadam, 免费的大餐所吸引。
But they go on to become very good devotees and do a lot of service for Krishna.
但是逐渐的他们 会成为好的奉献者，会做很好的服务给予 Krishna。
So in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadev Goswami says, it doesn't matter if you have a lot of material desires or no material desires, still you should worship the Supreme Lord.
因此 Sukadeva Goswami 在圣典薄伽瓦坛中提到，无论他是有各种物质愿望，还是说没有任何欲望，他都应该崇拜至尊主。
And we should only pray to the Supreme Lord. We shouldn't pray to anybody else to get what we want.
而且我们应该只向至尊主祈祷，不应该向其他任何人祈祷。
If we pray to the demigods, then that's crazy. That means we have no good intelligence.
如果我们向半神人祈祷，意味着我们是疯狂、丧失理智的，没有智慧的。
So Lakshmi tells all the devotees to approach the Supreme Lord, her husband, even if they have material desires.
因此 ，Lakshmi 告诫所有，即便是带着物质欲望的人去接近主的这些奉献者。
Now Lakshmi knows that the Lord, her husband, is Kamadev. He's Kamadev, he's the Lord of Kama, he's the Lord of love and lusty relationships.
她知道她的丈夫是 Kamadev, 她的丈夫是一切爱之主。
So there's no need to ask him for anything material.
因此没有必要向他索要任何物质的东西。
We should just simply serve him, and he knows what is in our heart.
他知道我们内心中的一切，因此没有必要向他索要任何的东西。
And because he knows what's in our heart, after some time, he will fulfill our desire.
因为他知道我们内心中的所有的一切，过了一段时间之后，他会满足我们的这些愿望。
So it's better just to serve him, but don't trouble him, don't bother him with your material requests, because he knows what you want. But just do your service, and he will arrange.
因此，最好的方法是只是去服务他，不要用你的物质愿望去打扰他。他知道你内心的物质愿望，过了一段时间，他会满足你的愿望的。
And then Lakshmi got, she's describing, she says, even Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva and other demigods and even the demons sometimes, they will do penances and austerities to get benedictions from Lakshmi.
Lakshmi 这个时候又向主祈祷道, 他的描述说, 即便有时候主 Brahma, 主 Shiva, 还有其他的一些办事人, 甚至恶魔们, 他们也会经历一些忏悔以及苦行，想获得 Lakshmi Devi 他本人的祝福。
Yeah, sometimes you know they become, they have a thought of enjoying material life. They want something. They want to enjoy material life, so they may do these austerities and penances to get blessing from Lakshmi.
因为有一些时候，他们想享受这个物质世界，想有各种享受的愿望，所以他们想向这个 Lakshmi Devi 祈求祝福。
But Lakshmi says, I don't give them what they want. He said, even if they may be very great, I won't fulfill their desire unless he's serving the lotus feet of her husband.
但是 Lakshmi Devi 说，不管他们这些人多么的伟大，除非他恒常的从事奉献服务，服务我的这个主，我的丈夫，我不会，否则的话，我不会赐福和宠爱他，给予祝福，给予他。Yeah,
the husband of Lakshmi is the Supreme Lord Vishnu, and she said, I always keep my husband, my Lord, in my heart, and so I cannot give blessings to anyone except a devotee. They should be devoted to my husband, then I can please them.
因为Lakshmi是主Vishnu Narayana的他的妻子，他不可能给予这些其他人祝福，除非他是主 Krishna, 主 Vishnu 的奉献者。
She doesn't give her favor to any materialistic person.
她不会给予任何物质主义者恩宠。
Sometimes materialistic people become very powerful, very opulent.
有些时候这些物质主义者看起来非常的富裕，非常的有力量。
And that opulence may be given by Durga, it's not given by Lakshmi.
但是这种富裕或者说 力量有可能是被是Durga女神给予的，而不是Lakshmi Devi 给予的。
And Durga, she's an expansion of Lakshmi.
Durga 实际上是 Lakshmi Devi 的扩展。
So Durga Devi may give them some material blessings.
Durga Devi 或许给予他们一些物质的祝福。
There's a prayer which they offer, they say to Durga, Mother Durga, please give me wealth, strength, fame, a good wife.
有一个祈祷文这么给予着向 Durga Devi 的祈祷，请给予我财富、力量、名声以及一个好的妻子等等。
And if they can please Goddess Durga, then they can get these things. But the result is only temporary. These things are only temporary. So it's just another illusion.
但是这些事情，这些好处的结果是非常短暂的，也会导致愚昧。
It's called Maya Sukaya, the happiness of illusion.
这被称为 Maya Sukaya, 虚幻的快乐。
Prahlad Maharaj said people work very hard for these material benefits. They're very stupid.
Prahlad Maharaj 说这些非常努力的工作想获得物质好处的人非常的愚蠢。
Because this happiness will not last any time. It's very quickly finished.
因为这样的快乐并不会很持久 很快就会结束
But devotees like Prahlad and Dhruva Maharaj they became very very wealthy they got a lot of material opulence
但是像 Prahlad 和 Dhruva Maharaj 这样的奉献者他们却得到了非常多非凡的物质的富裕
But they get the opulence that's not Maya Sukha.That is given to them by the goddess of fortune.
但是他们所得到的富裕并不是玛雅苏卡，他们所得到的富裕是幸运女神给予他们的。
Goddess of fortune, she's the consort of Lord Narayan, and she's happy to give to his devotees.
幸运女神是拉尔扬纳的伴侣，她非常高兴地给予奉献者礼物。
But you offer prayers to Durga, you get only temporary benefit.
我们向 Durga 女神供奉祷文，我们得到的物质富裕是非常短暂的。
Prabhupada told us there was one of his god brothers, in other words, a disciple of Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, and this disciple wanted to enjoy the property of his guru.
圣帕帕的描述到他的一位神兄弟也就是圣巴提西丹塔萨尔萨基塔库的另一位门徒他想得到他咕噜的灵性导师的这些财产
So his guru was merciful to him and he gave the property to him
他的灵性导师对他非常仁慈所以给予了这个门徒一些财产
But he didn't give the power to preach the message of Lord Chaitanya all over the world
但是他并没有给予他这种 Chaitanya 所赋予的这种传教的力量。
No, he just gave him the property. Let him sit in the property and enjoy the property.
他只是给了他一些财产，让他去享受这些财产。
But he didn't go and preach all over the world.
但是他并没有去全世界传播的这种力量，他并没有得到这种传播的力量。
But that special mercy, that power to preach all over the world, that was given to a devotee who doesn't want anything material from his guru.
这种特殊的仁慈，这种传教的力量，是给予那些不渴望从灵性导师那里获得物质东西的奉献者。
He wants only to serve his guru.
这样的奉献者只是想去服务他的灵性导师。
Just like Srila Prabhupada, he didn't worry about the property of his guru. He just wanted to preach on behalf of his guru.
就像圣帕帕德，他不想去从他的灵性导师那里要得什么财产，他只想去服务他的 guru， 他只想去传播。
And the same way the demon Ravan.Ravan tried to take the goddess of fortune Sita Devi from Lord Ramachandra.
就像 Ravana, 恶魔 Ravana, 他想从主 Ramachandra 那里劫走 Sita Devi.
But what happened was he took the Maya Sita, he didn't take the real Sita.
但是事实上他只是带走了那一位 Maya Sita, 而不是真正的 Sita.
The real Sita, she cannot be touched by a demon like Rava.
真正的 Sita Devi 不可能被 Ravana 这样的恶魔所触碰。
So the woman he took was like an expansion of Durga Devi. It was a Maya Sita.
所以 Ravana 所触碰的是 Maya Sita 或者 Durga Devi.
So you see, Ravan, he didn't get the mercy of the goddess of fortune.
因此 Ravana 并没有得到星云女神的恩宠。
But his whole family were killed by the power of Durga Devi.
而且他的整个家庭都被 Durga Devi 的力量给摧毁了。
Mother Durga does these things.
Durga 母亲做了这些事情。
She destroys the demons. It's also her service for the Supreme Lord.
这也是 Durga 女神她的服务，她做了所有的，她摧毁了他们的家庭。
So Lakshmi continues to offer her prayers. She says that the lotus hand of the Lord.Is it where we get all the benedictions, all the blessings come from the hand of the Lord?
星云女神继续祈祷道：“至尊主的莲花手掌是所有祝福的源头。”
And when the Lord is very merciful to his pure devotees, he will place his hand on their head.
当至尊人格守神。非常仁慈的对奉献者非常仁慈的时候，他就会把这个手放到他们的头上。
So Lakshmi says, I hope that one day you will place your hand on my head.
所以他祈祷道，我希望有一天您也能把您的手放在我的头上。
Now Lakshmi, she already has some mark on the chest of the Lord. There's some golden line on the chest of the Lord, and that represents Lakshmi.
至尊主的胸膛上虽然有一些金色条纹的徽章，这些徽章事实上象征的是 Lakshmi Devi。
But Lakshmi says, Lakshmi tells the Lord, Lord Narayan, that this is just my, you know, I'm not worthy of this honor. It just makes me proud. I don't deserve this.
但是 Lakshmi Devi 说，这些徽章只是我并不值得拥有这些徽章，这只是我的骄傲而已。
Yeah, you give, she tells the Lord, you give your real mercy to your devotees, you don't give it to me, I don't get your real mercy.
Lakshmi Devi 说，你将你的真正仁慈赐予了您的奉献者，但是您并没有把这个仁慈赐予我。
But still, you are the supreme controller and nobody can understand your plan.
您是至尊绝对的控制者，没有人能理解您的计划。
So we often see in the scriptures it's like that the Supreme Personality of Godhead is more attached to his devotees than to his own wife.
我们在很多的经典中描述中都可以看到，至尊人格守神对奉献者甚至比对他的妻子还要亲切。
Although Lakshmi is always there on his chest,The Lord is more inclined to the devotees.
虽然 Lakshmi 永远都在至尊主的胸膛处，但是至尊主非常对奉献者非常的亲切。
Krishna says his devotees are more dear to him than Brahma or Shiva or even Lakshmi.
Krishna 至尊人格守神坦白地说，比起主 Brahma、主 Shiva。幸运女神 Lakshmi 来说，奉献者更为的亲切。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Goswami said Krishna gave more mercy to the gopis than to Lord Brahma or Lord Shiva or even to the goddess of fortune, who is his own wife. So not Krishna, but Vishnu.
在圣典薄伽瓦坛中 ，Sukadeva Goswami 说。至尊主甚至对 Gopi 们所展出的仁慈和爱多于主 Brahma、主 Shiva 甚至他的妻子。
So the Gopis, they got benedictions from the Lord that neither Lakshmi or any of the heavenly women could ever come in the Rasa dance.
Gopi 物流姑娘们从主那里得到了赐福， 而这些 Lakshmi 或者说天堂星宿的这些舞蹈家们却没有办法获得这种祝福。
Krishna gives his favor only to the gopis. He puts his arms on their shoulders and dances with them. He doesn't do that with these other women.
Krishna 只是把这种恩宠给予了木流姑娘们 gopi 们，他把肩膀放在他们的身上，单独与他们每一位跳舞，但是没有其他的女士得到这样的恩宠。
So the gopis, they get the special mercy of the Supreme Lord.
木流姑娘们得到了至尊主特别的恩宠。
And the Chaitanya Charitamrita is told also about how a devotee has to follow in the footsteps of the gopis to get the real mercy of Krishna.
在永恒的柴檀尼亚经说，如不追随 gopi 们的步伐，不能够获得至尊人格守神真正的恩宠。
So the goddess of fortune, she couldn't do that. She wasn't able to follow the example of the gopis.
所以幸运女神无法获得和 gopi 们同样的这种恩宠。
But she did austerities and penances for many years, but she was not able to become a gopi.
虽然她经历了很多的苦行，很多年的苦行和忏悔，但是她仍没有办法成为 gopi。
So when Lord Chaitanya was traveling in India, he went to Sri Rangam. He went to the place in Sri Rangam where there's a big temple called Ranganath. And he stayed in the home of a Brahmana there. And they talked about Lakshmi and how she did austerities.
除 Chaitanya 在旅行的时候，他去了一个叫 Sri Ranga 的地方，他在那里碰到了一位婆罗门。他和这位婆罗门就谈论了这个关于 Lakshmi 的这个事情。
Yeah, the Brahmana who he was staying with, he was in the Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya. So they worship Lakshmi Narayan.
这位婆罗门他是 Sri Vaishnava 的师徒传信，他崇拜的是 Lakshmi Narayan。
And they say Lakshmi is the supreme. They don't say Radha, they say Lakshmi.And they don't say Krishna, they say Narayan.
他们说至尊的是 Lakshmi 和 Narayana, 但是他们并不说 Radha 和 Krishna 是至尊。
So Lord Chaitanya was explaining to them about the superiority of Radha and Krishna worship.
所以主 Chaitanya 向他解释了对 Sri Radha 和 Krishna 崇拜的至尊性。
So Lord Chaitanya said to the Sri Vaishnava, Brahmana, he said to him that, you know, you worship Lakshmi and she always stays on the chest of Narayan.
他对这位 Sri Vaishnava, 就是 Sri 传系的这个奉献者说，你值得崇拜的这个幸运女神。
And she's very chaste. She always stays there with her husband, Lord Narayan.
你崇拜的幸运女神 Lakshmi Devi, 她是最贞洁的女人，她总是处在 Narayana 的胸膛。
But Lord Chaitanya said, I worship Krishna. He's a cowherd boy. He's always taking care of the cows.
主 Chaitanya 说，我崇拜的是一位牧牛童，他总是在照顾母牛。
So Lord Chaitanya said, why is it that Lakshmi, who is so chaste,Why does she want to associate with Krishna?
主 Chaitanya 就问道，为什么一位如此贞洁的 Lakshmi Devi 竟然想和 Krishna 联谊呢？
And she even went to Vrindavan, she left Vaikuntha, and she came and stayed in Vrindavan for a long time to do austerities.
而且她做了很多的苦行，甚至离开了 Vaikuntha。来到了文达文，在文达文待了很长的时间。
So Venkatabhata said to Lord Chaitanya, he said, well, Lord Krishna, Lord Narayan, they're the same. It's the same person.
这位婆罗门温卡塔巴塔就说，事实上 Narayana 和 Krishna 是一样的，他们都是至尊主。
Just Krishna has more fun, he has more pastimes, more pleasure than Narayana.
但是 Krishna 的 Krishna 比 Narayana 更具有味道，更有意思。
But they're both the same.
但是他们是同一位。
So if Lakshmi went to associate with Krishna, she's still chaste. She didn't lose her chastity.
所以当 Lakshmi 和 Krishna 在联谊的时候，她仍然是很贞洁的。她事实上和同一位至尊主在联谊。
No, she just wanted to have some fun with Lord Krishna.
她只是想和 Krishna 有一些有趣的事情。
But she thought, Lakshmi thought that if she could be with Krishna, she could also join the Ratha dance.
幸运女神 Lakshmi Devi 她想着，如果她和 Krishna 在一起，她也想加入到这种 Ratha 之舞之中。
So there's nothing wrong with this. It's okay.
因此，她认为这个事情并没有错，这是可以的。
So Lord Chaitanya said, "Yeah." He said, "I know there's no fault on the part of Lakshmi. She's still chaste, but she could not go into the rasa dance."
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 回答道，我知道幸运女神并没有什么错，没有过失，但是她仍然不能进入到 rasa 之舞之中。
And Lord Chaitanya described, he said that.The authorities of the Vedic knowledge met Lord Ramachandra in the forest.
主 Chaitanya 说，伟达知识的权威们在这个森林中遇到了主 Ramachandra.
And Lord Ramachandra blessed them that they could, in the next life, they would be able to come into the Rasa dance.
主 Ramachandra 祝福了他们，他们被在下一生的时候可以允许进入到 Rasa 之舞之中。
But Lord Chaitanya said, Lakshmi never could get in that opportunity. She couldn't get into the Rasa dance.
但是主 Chaitanya 又非常疑惑地问道，为什么 Lakshmi Devi 她至今都无法得到这种机会呢？进入到 Rasa 之舞呢
？So the Brahmana.Who is a Sri Vaishnava? He says, "Well, I don't know." He said, "I can't explain this." He said, "This is beyond my understanding."
So, this Brahmana, this Sri Vaishnava, said, "This 完全超乎我的这种知识和理解的范畴。我无法知道这件事情的奥秘。
He said, "I'm just an ordinary person. My intelligence is limited."
我只是一个普通的生物，我的智力非常的有限。
How can I ever understand the pastimes of the Supreme Lord?
我如何能理解至尊主的逍遥时光呢？
So Lord Chaitanya told him, he said, Krishna has a very special character.
主 Chaitanya 回答道，主 Krishna 具有一个特殊的品质。
He attracts everyone by his pastimes.
他通过他的逍遥时光吸引每一个人。
If you follow the inhabitants of Goloka, the planet known as Goloka, then you can get the shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna.
通过追随 Goloka 居民的脚步，一个人可以获得 Krishna 莲花座的庇护。
But you should understand.That the people, all the people who live on that planet, the Goloka planet, they don't know that Krishna is the Supreme Lord. They just think of him as the son of Nanda Maharaj.
然而，你应该知道，在那个星球的居民都不知道主 Krishna 是至尊人格首身，他们只知道 Krishna 是 Nanda Maharaj 的儿子。
So Mother Yashoda, Nanda Maharaj, they just see Krishna as their son.And that's why Mother Yashoda bound Krishna up.
So, Nanda Maharaj Yashoda 只是认为 Krishna 是他的儿子，而且还把 Krishna 给绑了起来。Yashoda 把 Krishna 给绑了起来。
And all the cowherd boys there, who are all Krishna's age, they think Krishna's just an ordinary boy.
所有这些牧牛童们认为 Krishna 只是一个普通的男孩。
And that's why they get on his shoulders. They don't think that he's God.
因此，他们骑在 Krishna 的肩膀上，他们不认为 Krishna 是神。
And even if Krishna tells them he's God, they'll laugh at him.
即便 Krishna 告诉他们他是神，但是这些牧牛童们却嘲笑他。
Just like one time Krishna said, "Don't you remember when I was 7 years old, I held up the Govardhan Hill for a week with a little finger of my left hand?"
有一次 ，Krishna 就跟这些朋友们说：“你们不记得了吗？当我是7岁的时候，我用我左手的小拇指把戈尔瓦纳山举起了7天7夜。”
But all the cowherd boys, they collapsed on the ground and they rolled around laughing at Krishna, and they thought so funny.
但是所有这些牧牛童们就使劲地拍打着地板，然后笑着，然后在地上打着滚，非常就嘲笑着 Krishna。
And then they said to Krishna, "Oh, come on, Krishna, don't you know it was because we offered the worship of Govardhan? So Govardhan was so happy that he floated up in the air, and you just stuck your finger underneath and pretended you were holding him up."
这个牧牛童们就跟 Krishna 说，没事吧 ，Krishna。这你不记得了吗？是我们崇拜了戈尔巴丹山，所以戈尔巴丹山当时自然而然它就飞起来了。你只是用你的小拇指在那里点着，你假装举起了戈尔巴丹山而已。
So this way, the people in Goloka they only think of Krishna like an ordinary boy like them, and they don't have any desire. They don't have any material. They only love Krishna.
所以在格罗卡的这些牧牛童、这些奉修人、这些居民们，他们不认为 Krishna 是神，他们只是认为 Krishna 是一个普通的人，而且他们没有任何别的物质愿望。
So Lakshmi is saying that if somebody wants to associate with Krishna, he has to get the blessings of the inhabitants of Braja, of Vrindavan. They have to bless him.
因此，如果一个人想要和 Krishna 获得联谊，除非他得到 Braja Bhumi， 就是这些圣地居民他们的恩宠，否则他无法和 Krishna 联谊。
And if you want to get free, if you want to get Krishna's mercy, you must serve the people of Vrindavan.
如果你想获得拯救的话，你想被 Krishna 所拯救的话，你必须服务文达文的居民们。
Because they are all the pure devotees of the Lord.
因为他们全都是主纯粹的奉献者。
Okay, so now we're going on to another part of Jambudvip. This is called Ramyaka Vasha.
下面我们去到 Jambudvip 的另外一个地方，这个地方叫 Ramyaka Vasha.
And Vaivashvatamanu is ruling there.
在这里的统治者是 Vaivasvaka Manu， 他统治着。
And the Supreme Personality of Godhead appears there as Lord Matsya。
至尊人格首神在那里显现为主 Matsya。
That's at the end of the Chaksuta, at the end of the last era。
这是最后一个年代显现的。
So Vaivasvata Manu worships Lord Matsya.In pure devotion and chants a wonderful mantra.
Vaivasvata Manu 在纯洁的奉爱服务中崇拜主 Matsya， 唱诵曼陀罗。
So he prays to Lord Matsya that, I know that you are completely transcendental, nothing material.
他祈祷道：“我知道您是纯粹的超然者，没有任何的物质。”
And I know that from you, there's great bodily strength and mental power.
从您那里产生的所有的生命、心意的力量。
And ability of the senses, it all comes from you.
身体的力量、感官的力量都是来自于您。
I know that you're Matsya Avatar, and you were the first of the Lord's incarnations. After he appears, after the Lord creates, the first of the incarnations is Matsya.
您是 Matsya Avatar, 您是这个创造中所有化身的第一位。
So, Vaiveshvata Manu said, I bow down to you, I offer my obeisances.
我顶拜您，我向您致以虔敬的顶拜。
So, it happened that after the creation, the planet was covered with water. So at that time, Krishna arranged for the Matsya incarnation.
在宇宙创造之后就被水淹没，所以主 Krishna 化身为 Matsya。
And the Matsya incarnation protects the Vedas.
Matsya 的这个化身保护了伟达经。
You may think fish, generally we think of fish, they're the mode of ignorance and some passion. But we should understand when the Lord comes as a fish, He's not in the mode of ignorance or passion.
通常鱼被认为是愚昧属性和激情属性的混合，但是当主显现为 Matsya 这个鱼的化身时，它完全不是物质的激情属性和愚昧的属性的混合，它是完全超然的。
So, the Lord is always in pure goodness. So, there are many other incarnations of the Lord, and they're all pure transcendental. Even when He comes as a boar, or as a turtle, or as a half lion, half man.
主的化身的这些属性是纯粹善良属性。即便主有时候化身为雄猪的属性、乌龟的属性、马的这个属性，我们都应该认为它是超然的。
They're always pure, Shuddha Sattva, transcendental to the mode of goodness.
它们属于 Shuddha Sattva, 纯粹的、超然的、善良属性的层面上。
So, Vaiveshvata Manu prays to Lord Matsya. He said, just like somebody has puppets, so by his puppets he can make the puppets dance.
他祈祷道，就像一位操控木偶的人控制跳舞的木偶一样。
Or just like a husband can control his wife.The same way, Lord Matsya controls all the living entities in the universe.
就像丈夫控制妻子一样，就像操控木偶的人控制跳舞的木偶一样，您 Matsya Devi, Matsya 控制着所有的生物。
Yeah, the Brahmins, the Kshatriya, the Vaishya, Sudra, they're all under the Lord's control.
像 Brahma, Vaishya,Kshatriya, Sudra, 他们全都在至尊主的控制之下。
So Vaiveshvata says, I know you're in everyone's heart as a super soul.
我知道您以超念的形式处在每一个众生的心中。
And you're outside of everyone as well. You're not only in their heart, you're outside as well, so you can see everything which is taking place.
您也在每一个人的心的外面。
But these so-called people, the leaders, these so-called big men, they cannot understand you. They cannot appreciate your position.
但是这些所谓的领袖们，这些所谓的人士或者说神们，他们却不能理解您的地位。
If they don't hear the Vedic mantras, then they can never appreciate, they can never understand you.
除非一个人聆听伟大的曼陀罗，他才能够了解你。
So the Lord, because He's in everyone's heart, He can create knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness.
至尊主在每一个人的生物的心中，所以他创造了记忆、知识和遗忘。
So.Queen Kunti described like that you're inside, you're like an actor, you're like an actor on a stage, nobody recognizes you.
Kunti Devi, 她这样祈祷道，也这样祈祷道， 您就像一位演员的扮演者，没有人知道您真正的地位。
You're within the heart as the super soul. You're the witness there. You see everything. And at the same time, you're outside of everything.
您是超灵，担任着见证者，看着一切。您也居住在人们的外面。
But nobody, ordinary people, they're blind. They cannot see the Lord.
但是普通的人，他们是瞎子，他们无法看见至尊主。
Just like children, when they see puppets, they don't know somebody's pulling the string, somebody's controlling the puppets.
就像这些小孩们，如果他们在看这些木偶玩的时候，他们不知道这些木偶实际上是被操控的。
In the same way, the woman is also under the control of her husband.
同样，一位妇女，她是被丈夫所控制。
Women should always be protected and taken care of by a man, by their husband.
妇女应该总是被她的丈夫所保护、所照顾。
For a woman to be independent is not good. It makes them very proud and creates a lot of problems in society.
如果妇女想保持独立的话，对整个社会并不很好，对于她们也不好。
But of course, we're all, men are also dependent on Krishna. We're also not independent. We also have to depend on Krishna.
事实上，我们这些男的也不是独立的，我们都不是独立于 Krishna 存在的，我们都依赖主。
So, some people are so foolish, they say there's no God, but God is there for the intelligent people.
有一些很愚蠢的人说没有神，但是事实上神就在那里。
So intelligent people, they will recognize the Lord there in the heart, and they will surrender.
有智，
they will surrender.
有智慧的人，他能认识到至尊主就在每一个人的心里，他会臣服。
Okay. So even Brahma and other demigods and different leaders, they're all envious of the position of the authority of the Supreme Lord. They all want to get his position.
事实上，即便是主 Brahma， 还有其他的一些办事人，还有这些世界上的一些领袖们，全都嫉妒主的权威和地位。
But they can never maintain all the people in the universe.
但是他们却无法能够维系整个宇宙。
Only the Supreme Lord can do that. He can maintain all the living entities.
只有至尊主能够做到这一切，他能够维系整个宇宙的所有一切生物。
And the animals and the cows and the birds.
动物、母牛、鸟类。
Everything which is visible in the world is all being maintained by the Supreme Lord.
世界上可见的一切生物都是被至尊主所维系着。
Stupid people, they try to compete. They try to make themselves powerful, to make themselves appear powerful, almost like God.
有一些愚蠢的物质主义者把他们的力量与至尊主相竞争。
And scientists, you see the scientists, they're trying to do things, they're trying to control the material nature.
有一些科学家们想控制物质自然的能量。
They're trying to make themselves gods, greater. They want to prove they're greater than God.
他们想让他们变成至尊主，他们想让自己变得比至尊主还要伟大。
So everyone in the material world, even Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva, they get sometimes puffed up. They forget their position.
所以，即便像主 Brahma、主 Shiva 这样的高等星球的人，他们也有时候会忘记至尊主的存在。
You get social workers, and they talk that they want to help the poor, they want to feed the poor people. And they may criticize devotees. that oh, you're wasting your time. Why don't you do something useful like feed the poor?
我们也看到有一些慈善家们，他们给这些穷人一些布施，或者说资助了这些穷人之后，他们甚至来批评奉献者，你们这些奉献者只是在浪费时间，你看看我们在给这些穷人在给他们喂食。
But they're feeding the poor doesn't solve any problems in the world, doesn't solve the problem. Still people are going to be poor.
但是他们给这些穷人提供食物，并没有解决他们的真正的问题。
People, you get these so-called swamis, they'd rather feed the poor people rather than offer food to the deities, they'd rather give the food to the poor people.
有一些所谓的这个 swami 们，他们会说，宁愿把这个食物给予这些穷人，也不愿意把食物供奉给神像。
Yeah, this is better to feed the starving people than to serve the deity.
他们说，比这个服务神像更好的是服务这些穷人。
But we see that their service to the poor people, it hasn't changed the world. It hasn't helped anything. It hasn't done any good.
但是我们会可以看到他们帮助这些穷苦的这些人民，给予他们食物，并没有解决掉世界上的这些根本的这些问题。
We're all maintained by the grace of the Supreme Lord.
Sorry?
We're all maintained by the mercy of the Supreme Lord.
事实上我们都是被至尊主所维系着。
It's the Supreme Lord who is actually taking care of everyone.
事实上是至尊主在维系着每照顾着每一个人。
The rich man who's doing a little charity, he thinks I'm maintaining these people, but he's maintained by the Supreme Lord.
有一些富人做了一点点的布施和这个布施，他就认为哦，我在维系这些穷人。事实上，这个富人也在被至尊主所维系着。
And in Srimad Bhagavatam, we hear about how Lord Brahma, how he becomes illusioned, he becomes proud, and tried to create some problem for Lord Krishna.
我们可以看到圣典波迦瓦坛，主 Brahma 也产生了骄傲，被堕入到虚幻之中。他给 Krishna 造成了一些麻烦。
And Indra also, he did the same thing, he made trouble for the Lord, and that's why we got Govardhan Puja.
Indra 也给这个主 Krishna 造成了一些麻烦，所以我们有了这个哥瓦达山的铺甲。
Okay, so we will stop here.
好，我们今天先停到这儿。
We'll ask if there's any questions.
Yes.OK， 第一个问题来自于 Gloka Yoga 蒋秀辉，请问 Guru， 孩子不听话，不写作业，说话过分，这样的情况下能打他吗 ？I want to ask a Guru, when the child are not listening to us, not writing his homework, and speak some nonsense, in this condition, can I beat them?
No, that's not the recommended process of dealing with the disobedient child.
打孩子并不是被推荐的方式。
You have to find some other ways to deal with the child. That's not going to help the child just by beating him.
打孩子并不能解决方式，我们应该找到其他一些和孩子相处的方式。
You have to speak to the child, and you have to think of some other more appropriate means to punish the child. You may tell the child you're not allowed to go out. You cannot watch television. You can't play with your mobile phone. You just have to do your homework.
我们可以和孩子换一种交流方式。你可以跟他讲。你如果不做作业的话，我不给你看手机，也不给你玩电脑，你也不可以出去，类似这样。
But you have to talk to the child in a manner in which he can understand that you really care about him and you want to help him.
你也可以告诉孩子，你非常爱他，非常关心他，你也非常想帮助他。
But simply beating him, that's not the solution.
只是打他并不是解决问题的方法。
Prabhupada did not approve of that.
Prabhupada, 圣帕帕德没有说这一点。
Nowadays, you know, in schools, they used to have the system, they used to beat the students. But nowadays, they don't do that.
Sorry, Gurudev, in nowadays, has the...
In the past, they used to beat
students.
The teachers had the, they had the power to beat students, use a cane and beat them or punish them. But now they're not allowed to do that.
Okay, 在过去的教育系统之中，有这个打孩子的这个存在，比如说打孩子、鞭打孩子，他出现了问题。但是现在的这个教育之中是不允许这样做的。
No, they found that's not very effective way of dealing with the children.
因为人们发现这个方法并不是有效的方法，和孩子相处的时候并不有效。
The child will come and get revenge on the teacher.
这个孩子有时候甚至会复仇，对于这些老师鞭打他的老师。
They'll find the teacher's car and they'll scratch the car and they'll puncture the tires.
这个孩子甚至会找到这个老师的车，把他的轮胎给扎破等等这样。
So. What to do with the children if they misbehave? They send them home. They say, we don't want you in the school. If you're not going to behave properly, you can't come to this school. You go home.
如果孩子的行为方法不好的话，他可以回家。
Look, we don't need you in the school. You're not a good student. You don't want to study. You just create trouble. So go home.
学校会说，你不想学，你不想学习。你不想做作业，你不听话，那就回家。
So that's the punishment for the child.
这是对孩子的一种惩罚。
So some children, they don't want to do the homework, they don't want to study. Then, okay, then you have to go and get a job. Go to work. We'll send you to work.
有些孩子不想写作业，不想学习，那就跟他说：“你去工作吧，那就去找一份工作。”
Right. We'll get you a job. You go and work in the fields, work with the farmers, go out in the fields every day in the hot sun and work there in the fields.
那就让你到田里去干活，然后和那些农民和在一起，每天从早上干到晚上，在烈日炎炎之下去种田去。
So like that, you have to use some intelligence and think how to create the proper impression on the child.
所以就像这样，你找到一些别的方法和孩子沟通。Next question.
Yes.
Next question from the 淡然一笑 Lakshmi 知道 Krishna 就是 Narayana 吗 Does Lakshmi Devi know Krishna is Narayana?
Yes.
是的
But there are some differences.
但是也有一些不同
There are some subtle distinctions, just like, you know, Krishna has very special pastimes which are different from Lord Narayana.
他们有一些精微的不同，就像 Krishna 有一些很特别的逍遥时光。
Krishna has also very special friends.
Krishna 也有很特别的朋友。
And Krishna has also the flute, plays the flute.
Krishna 也可以吹笛子。
So there are some differences between Krishna and Narayana.
所以在 Krishna 和 Narayana 之间也有一些区别。
But Lakshmi understands, you know, she's a chaste woman, she's going after somebody, she thinks Krishna is also Narayana, so she's desiring to take part in that rasa dance.
Lakshmi Devi 是一位真觉的女士，她知道Narayana 跟 Krishna 是同一位，所以她想参加 Krishna 的这个 rasa dance.
But she's not able to do it because she's the goddess of fortune. She's not a gopi, and this rasa dance is only for gopis.
但是她做不到这一点，因为 rasa 之舞它只是为 gopi 们准备的。Lakshmi Devi 她是幸运女神，她不是 gopi， 她不是木柳姑娘。
Even the personified Vedas who took part in the rasa dance.But before they could take part in the rasa dance, the personified Vedas had to take birth in the family of Brijbasi people. They took birth as gopis, and then they came and danced and wrestled.
即便我们刚刚提到的这些伟达权威们，他们最后参加到 rasa 之舞之中，但是在他们的潜意识，他们必须成为这些 Brijbasi 就是圣地居民。这些木流姑娘们的 这些圣地居民的孩子，然后在下一世他们才能够参加到 Rasa 之舞的逍遥时光之舞。
But Lakshmi is not willing to do that. She's not able to do that.
但是 Lakshmi Devi 她不能够这样进入到之中。
And、so Krishna gave her a place on his chest. The golden line is there on the chest and that symbolizes the goddess of fortune.
所以 Krishna 给了他另外一个地位，让他在他的胸膛上， Krishna 胸膛上这些金色的这个徽章就象征了 Lakshmi Devi 的地位。
Mm-hmm. Any other question?
Yes. Dimbai Gurudev.做服务时感到开心就是取悦 Krishna， 反之就不是，是这样吗？ Obeisance to Gurudev. When I do the devotional service, I feel happy. I think this is please Krishna. If not, I think this is not please Krishna. Is that right?
Yes, you're right. If you do devotional service, you're pleasing Krishna.Of course, you should never be satisfied that you've done enough to please Krishna. You should always want to do more. It's not the activity, but it's the actual mood that we're actually doing the service with love for Krishna.
是的，做服务取悦就是取悦 Krishna， 做服务就是取悦 Krishna。但是呢，你不是每一次都会感到开心或满意。我们做服务不是说这个活动的本身是取悦 Krishna， 而是我们在做活动的时候以一种分外之心，这种爱是取悦 Krishna。
嗯，所以 yeah， giving pleasure to Krishna， that's natural. When we serve Krishna, we feel pleasure.And because Krishna is pleased, we feel pleasure.
因为我们先是取悦了 Krishna, 我们才会开心。
Not only we feel pleasure, but everyone feels pleasure. When Krishna is happy, Krishna is in the heart of everyone. So it's pleasing to everyone.
不仅仅是 Krishna 开心，应该是所有人开心。因为 Krishna 在所有人的内心之中，当所有人其他的人开心时，是更好。
嗯。 还有问题吗？
还有来自淡然一笑，幸运女神，哦，幸运女神如果知道自己的丈夫是哪样的，为什么？幸运女神知道自己的丈夫是丈夫哪样的，就是 Krishna 吗？如果知道，为什么自己还要去跳 Rasa 之舞，请求自己的丈夫哪样的变成 Krishna， 两人跳舞就可以了。So, this Mataji also then ask if the Lakshmi Devi know Narayana is Krishna, why not Narayana become Krishna and then she dance with Narayana or Krishna is then the dream become true?
Because it's a different mood. The Rasa Lila, that Rasa Lila is very special, you see. It's not, there are so many gopis there, and Krishna's with all the gopis. So Lakshmi also wants to be there, she wants to take part. She wants to experience that mood of being there with all the gopis and Krishna.
Because this is a different mindset. Lakshmi 也想加入到物流姑娘们的这个跳舞之中，他想他看到物流姑娘们和 Krishna 在一起，他也想加入到物流姑娘们之中和 Krishna 在一起。
Narayan, his mood is different from Krishna. He doesn't do these things like dance with the women. He's Narayan. He's the Lord of Vaikuntha. So he's worshipped with great majesty, with awe and reverence and respect. Krishna is very playful.
Narayana 和 Krishna 的这个心态是不一样的。Narayana 是 Vaikuntha 的主人，他是不会和这些女士们跳舞的，他是完全被尊敬的、被崇拜的一种状态。但是 Krishna 他是非常有趣的。好玩的。
Yeah, Krishna, he likes to enjoy. He's the supreme enjoyer, and he enjoys the company of all these beautiful women.
但是 Krishna 他是至尊享受者，他享受着和这些女性们的陪伴。
So Narayana, Lord Narayana, his mood is very different. His mood, he's the Lord of Vaikuntha, and he doesn't have that same kind of rasa with all the people. His mood, his worship, and Vaikuntha, the mood is dasharas. But Lord Krishna is in Goloka, and it's a different mood. There's all rasas there. Madhurya rasa. Conjugal love.
Narayana 和 Krishna 是完全不同的心态。他在 Vaikuntha， 他是 Vaikuntha 的主人，在 Vaikuntha 那里的心态，那里的关系是 Dasya Rasa 仆人的这种关系。但是呢，在 Goloka Vrindavan Krishna 那里是 Rasa 的源泉，那里有 Madhura Rasa 情侣的这种爱的关系。
对。You can't put Lord Narayan into Krishna's place.
所以他不能成为 Narayana 不能成为 Krishna 的这个位置。
You can't expect he's going to come off the throne and start dancing with all the women. That wouldn't be Lord Narayan anymore.
所以我们不能期望 Narayana 能和这些妇女们一起来跳舞吧，那就不再是 Narayana 了。
Yeah, you can't change people so easily like that, you know. Some people are very reserved and sophisticated, and other people are very playful.
我们不那么容易的可以去改变一些人。有一些人是很威严的，但是有一些人他就是很好玩的。
Any other question?
Yes. Next question from Rajendra Prabhu. 感谢亲爱的 Maharaj 的讲课，感谢亲爱的 Subhuti Raya 的翻译，感谢尊敬的 Sati 母亲主持。Krishna 满足所有奉献者的愿望，但我们看到 Krishna 只满足纯粹奉献者的愿望，没有满足 Karma Mishra Bhakta 的愿望，例如天帝 Indra。 是否 Krishna 也区别看情况赐予他的仁慈？ So thank you Maharaj for your lecture and Krishna please satisfy all the devotees the desire, but we also say that Krishna only satisfy the pure devotees desire, but not satisfy the Karma Mishra Bhakta's desire, for example like the Indra. So we want to know whether Krishna also distinguishes something, and in some condition he depending on the different situation, he give the different mercy.
Yes, actually Krishna satisfies everyone's desires, even the Karma Mishra devotees, their desires are satisfied, but not right away, and Krishna will consider first of all if it's actually good for them. If he doesn't satisfy their desire, he will purify their desire so that they won't desire material.
是的，事实上 Krishna 确实是满足每一个人的愿望，即便是 Karma Mishra Bhakta 的愿望他也满足，只不过 Krishna 没有立刻满足他的愿望， Krishna 会先思考一下是否这个愿望是正确的，然后再根据他的情况再满足他的愿望。
So Krishna is the well-wisher of everyone, and he tries to bring everyone into Krishna consciousness.
Krishna 是所有人的祝福者，他尝试着把所有人都带入到 Krishna 知觉之中。
So he will consider if this is actually good, what they're asking, if it's actually good for them, then he will fulfill their desire.
所以他会考虑 ，Krishna 会考虑是否这个愿望对于这个人他有对他有帮助，然后他才会看情况满足他的愿望。
We see Dhruva Maharaj, he worshipped Krishna to get a kingdom. Krishna gave him the kingdom.
我们看到 Dhruva Maharaj, 他想得到一个王国 ，Krishna 给予了他一个王国。
He made him stay there. He said, "Now you become king. You worship me to get this. Now you take it. You have to stay here and be the king."
Krishna 说你拿走吧，你崇拜我的时候就是想得到一个国王，现在我来了，我把这个你就拿走这个愿望，拿走这个国王王国。
Gajendra prayed to Krishna to save him from the crocodile. Vishnu came and killed the crocodile, saved Gajendra.
Gajendra 想让这个 Vishnu 来把他拯救出去，把他从鳄鱼的嘴巴中解救出去， Vishnu 来了，然后把这个鳄鱼给杀掉了，拯救了Gajendra。
So you can see Krishna does satisfy people's desires.
所以我们可以看到 Krishna 确实是在满足人们的愿望。
But he is most obliged to those who have got pure devotion.
但是他更被那些纯粹的奉献者所取悦。
And those who got pure devotion, they completely control Krishna.
那些得到纯粹奉献者的，得到纯粹服务的，这些纯粹奉献者，他们事实上能够控制 Krishna。
OK, 还有问题吗？
目前没有看到。
我们没有问题了，不对。
OK, 我们就先讲到这里啊。
好。
阿尔巴萨可不，我又提了一个问题，稍等。
哈尼瓦 Thomas Apapun 顶拜 Guru 经典没有地球上的建筑物或神像是上个年代循环年代来的证明四个年代循环的听说南印度的 Braj 是上个什么年代的比如金字塔又是哪个年代萨提玛的姐你能不能帮我解释一下这个今天上面那个年代就神像是上个年代循环证明
我也有点没读懂。
Harry Vamsa 可以讲。你们都听不懂啊。
In the part of this question, I know a little. I just explain a little. In the scriptures, there are.No constructions of the earth plant. I want to know, in the South Indian, the Braj, which, from which yoga?
The South Indian Vrindavan, Braja, is from which yoga?
South Indian, the Braj from the South Indian, from which yoga?
The Braj.
Yeah, Braj.
You mean Vrindavan?
I don't know this Braj. In South India.
不是，他说的是 Balaji, Balaji 吧，神像。
Oh, Balaji.
Balaji. Oh.
对。
Balaji 神像。
是来自于哪一个年代的
？It's from which yoga? Yeah, I don't know, but certainly been there a long time. Generally, we see like some of the deities which were made after Krishna departed from the world.You know, they started to make deities of Lord Krishna after he left the world. So they're 5,000 years old.
通常情况下，我们的解释是，这些神像都是在 Krishna 离开这个世界之后有的。
But the Balaji,
所以距今大概有5000年。
The Balaji deity, that's a Vishnu deity, that's...Could be a lot older. Could be a lot older than the Krishna deities.
但是巴拉吉的这个神像，它是主维什努的神像，因此它有可能会比 Krishna 的这个神像要更久远一些。He also asked the pyramid.
The pyramid in Egypt.
Yeah.Yes, yes.
Yes, when are they from?
Yeah.
Well, they're built by the Egyptians.
Egyptians.
Egypt, right? There's a country.
对对 Yes, yes. 埃及的 When they come from?
They're there. They've been there for about, what, 5,000 years or so?Or less?
Oh, 应该也是属于五千年之内的。
Yeah, the architects today are amazed how they could build such an amazing structure because it's so exactly built, so carefully built, that they could never build anything like that today.
这些建筑学家们确实在计算它的这个年限，因为在现在的这个年限是非常难以建造出这么精致的，而且这么仔细小心的这个建筑物的。
But the architect who built it, he's known. The name of the architect who built it, and they can put the exact date on the pyramids. That's not difficult. You can, you'd have to do a Google on it and you could find out.
嗯，你可以去 Google 或者百度一下。
嗯，哈利克什纳，
哈利
对，哈利当斯帕布他是想问，就是我们这个年代不是就是四个年代的循环吗？他就是想问，现在地球上有没有这种建筑啊，或者什么能够证明，在我们现在这个四个年代之前的年代的东西？
Well, in the Satya Yuga, the process was simply meditation. People would just simply meditate. They would just go off and meditate.
在 Satya Yuga 那个年代的人们只是冥想。
And then the Treta Yuga, Treta Yuga, they were doing yagyas.
在 Treta Yuga 他们做祭祀。
So there's still holy places. Some of these holy places are there. They've been holy places from the previous yugas.
确实有一些圣地是来自于先前的年代。
Of course, in the course of time, everything is destroyed. So,It's very difficult to show stuff from a previous yuga.
因为由于时间它能够摧毁一切，所以很难找到一些证物来证明先前的年代。
But when we go on Mayapur Parikrama, there's one place we go, there's a temple of the Gaudiya Math at this site, and it's a historic site, and they found stones there which are from the previous yuga.
当我们在拿瓦对帕的这个 Parikram 的时候，在高迪亚 Mat 旁边有一个角落，那里有一个石头是来自于上一个年代的，先前的年代的。
So it's a place. It's under the care of the Indian government, and it's a national historic site which they protect.
那是一个历史的文物的地方，被印度的政府所保护着起来。
So some deities in South India, some of them, they may be.From the Treta Yuga, because in Treta Yuga the process was deity worship.
在南印度有一些神像或许是来自于 Treta Yuga, 因为 Treta Yuga 他们是崇拜神像。
So some of the deities are very ancient, been there a very long time.
所以有一些神像非常的古老，在那里有很长的时间。
But in the past, you know, in the previous yugas, they did the worship in a simple way, you know, they didn't build big temples. That wasn't the process.
但是在过去，人们崇拜神像是以一种很简单的方式，崇拜的，他们并没有。
When we go to Nisringapalli, there's a place near Mayapur, Nisringapalli, the deity of Lord Nisringadev. They said that deity is there from previous yugas, it's a very ancient deity. And they said after Lord Nisringadev killed Hiranyakashipu, that he came to that place, Nisringapalli, to rest. And they said all the demigods came and all the stones and stuff over there on the other side of the river where the demigods all rested.
在 Mayapur 的这个绕拜的过程中，我们去到一个叫 Nisringapalli 的地方。当主 Nisringadev 杀了这个黑人亚卡西普，他在那个地方休息。然后这个时候所有的半神人都来了，在那条河岸边的那些石头都是半神人们所待的地方。
Then you have to deal with things like change the path of the rivers changing, you know, the Ganga moves its path, and the Yamuna moves its path. So a lot of things have been destroyed in the course of time.
很多东西都被时间所改变或者毁灭，我们还得考虑这个恒河、亚穆纳河改道啊等等这些问题的情况。
You can go to the Mathura Museum and look in the museums and see what they have there.
你可以去马图尔的这个博物馆看一看马图尔的那个博物馆有一些什么。
Just like Mathura Museum, they have a lot of Buddha things because Mathura used to be the capital of Buddhism.
Mathura 这个博物馆那里有很多佛教的一些东西，因为那 Mathura 在以前也是这个佛教的一个首都。
You have to understand Buddhism had a very strong influence. Like even 500 years ago, they were still quite active. Although it was Shankaracharya 1,000 years ago, he drove Buddhism out of India, but there were still some of them here.
虽然这个我们还得考虑佛教的这个情况，因为在佛教在之前他们是非常有影响力的，即便是在500年前也非常有影响力，在 Shankaracharya 的时候1000年前他们仍然也是很有影响力的。
And we can see the Jagannath temple, Jagannath deities, you know, that's also, you know, that's from this age, you know, these deities, the temples, ancient temple.
我们还可以看到那个加格纳的庙，也是非常古老的一个庙。
You can, there's a Vrindavan Research Institute in Vrindavan, and they have copies of the original books of the Goswamis, which were all written on palm leaves.
我们还可以在这个 Vrindavan, 它有一个 Vrindavan Research, Vrindavan 研究学院，那里可以找到六 Goswami 手写的这些东西。他们的这个手稿是用这个棕榈树叶写的。
So, you know, you have things, when time of Vyasadeva, there were no books printed, they wrote on palm leaves, and palm leaves don't last forever.
在 Vyasadeva 的那个年代，他们也没有，当时也没有印刷术，所以呢，所有的经典都是写在这个棕榈树叶上，棕榈树叶，但是并不能保持永久的这个时间，很长的时间。
But you could always go to the Himalayas if you want. Why don't you go to the Himalayas and look for Vyasadeva? Because Vyasadeva is somewhere up there in the Himalayas. And if you're very pious, you may be able to find him.
如果你非常虔诚的话，你可以去喜马拉雅山。你甚至如果非常非常虔诚，你可以在喜马拉雅山找到 Vyasadeva。Vyasadeva 就在那里。
Madhvacharya went there.
Madhvacharya 去过那里。
About 900 years ago.
900年之前。
So, you know, you want some verification, you want some proof? Go and find Vyasadeva.
你想要找到一些证明的话，你去喜马拉雅山去找 Vyasadeva。
You might be lucky, you know, sometimes the brother of Ravan, what's his name? The brother of Ravan, Ravan had one brother who joined Lord Rama and he became the king of Ayodhya. So he was told to worship Lord Jagannath, so sometimes he comes to Jagannath Puri to have darshan of Lord Jagannath.
Ravana 的一个兄弟，is that Vishwamitra?
No, not Vishwamitra.
Okay, Ravana 的一个兄弟，他被告知要去，他去崇拜这个主加格纳的。
name was Vibhishan.
Vibhishan, sorry, Harish.
So sometimes, you know, one devotee has met him one time. He met Lord Ramat's brother going to take darshan of Lord Jagannath.
有一个奉献者甚至碰到这个维比闪，他在去见这个加格纳的时候，他见到维比闪。
So you have to do more research yourself.
你应该自己做一些调查和研究，更多的调查和研究。
Go around and visit all the holy places and hear about what happened in these different places.
去拜访所有的这些圣地，去聆听这些圣地到底发生了些什么事情。
We know just trying to go back 5,000 years is very, very difficult.
我们知道仅仅是回到5000年前都是非常非常难的。
So you want to go back in the previous yugas, you really got a lot of trouble.
但是你想找到上个年代的事情，那就更大的困难和难度了。
Okay, so we will stop here tonight. Thank you very much.
好。
非常感谢 Subhuti Roy Prabhu 给我们今天的翻译。我们感谢 Sati Juju， 感谢所有的奉献者 Link Team 也 T1。祝福你们 ，Govardhan Puja 快乐。
感谢 Subhuti， 谢谢您的讲课，顶拜你。
Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Jai.